Welcome to the division of fractions. The goals of this video will be to perform division with fractions and also to verify division of fractions on the graphing calculator. Division of fractions. To divide two fractions, simply multiply by the reciprocal of the divisor. So notice how if this is our division problem, instead of dividing by C over D, we'll multiply by the reciprocal, which would be D over C. Just as when we are multiplying fractions, we will need to be sure to convert mixed numbers to improper fractions and also to simplify our final answers. Now I'd like to take a moment and kind of explain why we're allowed to do this. And really what I want to base it upon is what you already know about division. If I ask you to consider 6 divided by 2, you know the answer is 3, but really what we want to know is how many 2's are in 6. Or we could also think we want to divide 6 into 2's. So for example, if this is our model for 6, each rectangle equaling 1 unit, we could easily divide this into groups of 2. There's one, and there's another. And we can see the result would be 3 groups. Therefore, we can conclude and pretty much understand why 6 divided by 2 is equal to 3. Now, if we use the same train of thought to the problem 6 divided by 1/2, we really want to know how many halves are in 6. So looking at our model for 6 again, if we now want to break this up into halves, we would have to take each of these rectangles, which equal 1 unit, and cut them in half. And if we did that to these 6 rectangles, they would look something like this. And if I asked you, how many rectangles do we have now? Since all of them have been divided into half, you can see that we would have a total of 12 rectangles now. And that is the reason why 6 divided by 1/2 is equal to 12. Now that's kind of an involved process. So if we apply the rule that we've just discussed, that states that we can take 6 divided by 1/2 and we can multiply by the reciprocal instead. The reciprocal of 1/2, of course, is 2 over 1, which would be equal to 2, which would give us our answer as 12. Notice the result is obviously the same. Well, now that we understand the rule, let's go ahead and just apply it with a few more examples. 5/6 divided by 2/3 simply becomes 5/6 times 3/2. Now let's simplify before we multiply. We know we can break down 6 into its prime factors of 2 times 3, and we can easily see that the numerator and denominator have a common factor of 3. Now when we multiply across the top and the bottom, we would have 5/4, which is an improper fraction, and which would be 1 1/4 as a mixed number. It really depends on which form they ask the answer to be in. Here's another example. 5/8 divided by 1/4, well, that would become 5/8 times 4 over 1. Again, notice that we're not taking the reciprocal of the first term, just the divisor. Let's simplify. Now I'm in the habit of breaking everything down into prime factors, so I'm going to continue that for consistency. And again, we can easily see that there are some common factors there. So the result will now be in simplest form, 5/2, which again is an improper fraction. Let's review how to convert that to a mixed number. 5 divided by 2. 2 goes into 5 2 times with the remainder of 1. Therefore, 5/2 would be 2 1/2. Depending on how you learned how to divide fractions before, you may have simplified this in this manner. You may have noticed there's a common factor of 4. 4 goes into 4 1 time. 4 goes into 8 2 times, and so forth. That is another way to simplify fractions. Just for consistency, I will continue to use the prime factors. I mentioned I would show you on the graphing calculator how to verify these answers. So let's go ahead and verify this problem that we just did. So I'm going to enter in 5/8 in a set of parentheses, divide that by 1/4. Again, I'm putting the fraction in a set of parentheses. When I hit enter, it will give me the decimal value. But if I wanted to have it in fraction form, there are a couple of ways of doing that. If I hit math, enter, enter, that will show me the answer is 5/2. If I had 2.5 and I wanted to verify the mixed number, obviously 2 is going to be the whole number. If I subtract 2, that leaves the decimal portion. And now if I hit math, enter, enter, it will convert the decimal portion to the fraction of 1/2. Either way, we verify our answer. Let's take a look at a couple more examples. This one introduces a negative fraction. This would become 3/8 times negative 4/9. Again, I'm going to simplify before I multiply. 8 prime factors of 8 would be 2 times 2 times 2. Prime factors of 4, of course, are 2 times 2. 9 would be 3 times 3. And we've got to be careful, there is a negative sign here, so I'll put that there. Okay, simplifying. So our final answer would be, all of these are turning into 1, so we have a negative 1 over 6, or negative 1/6. Our last example introduces a mixed number. There's nothing special about this mixed number. The first thing we're going to do is convert it to an improper fraction. So 4 times 3 plus 3, 15/4, divided by, looks like 15/8. Converting this to a multiplication problem, 15/4 times 8/15. Now when I simplify this one, I will show you a little bit of a shortcut. Obviously we see the 15s are going to simplify, so I don't need to break those down into their prime factors. I also notice that 8 can break down into 2 times 4, so I'll leave 4 alone, break down 8 into 2 times 4, and this does save a little bit of time, but it's only useful if you really know your multiplication tables. And as you can see, the final answer here would be 2 over 1, which is of course equal to 2. I hope that helps explain how to do division with fractions. Thank you, and have a great day.